9:13. Now I'm going to wait for some more time. Okay, within 1 minute the class is going to start now. Is the screen is visible now?
Yes, ma'am.
In last class, we have seen logic-based testing. Logic-based testing. In this logic-based testing, what is the purpose of logic-based testing? Here we are going to test the logic only. Suppose we have main function like this. This is going to show you one example. Suppose there is a logic like this. This is a program, C program, right? Hash, include, and header files, main part, declaration of variables, printf, scanf statements, and then printing a big number among three numbers. I just have taken more conditions to represent in this decision table, okay? Otherwise, you can also use A greater than B, a single condition, nested if loop, and all, okay? But I'm not using that. This logic I'm using. Okay, in this logic, There are six conditions. A greater than B, A greater than C, B greater than C, B greater than A, C greater than A, C greater than B. A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. So we focus on this logic part only. We are not focusing on the remaining programming part here. We focus on this logic part. This logic part consists of the decisions. Okay. Then that means we are trying to build the decision tables from the logic. Okay. So here a decision table consists of this A, B, C, D, E, F, G, E, F, G, E, F, up to this. Okay. This many number of decisions. And then what about this? What about this? These are actions. Suppose if the decision A and B are true, then this action should be done. If B greater than C, B greater than A, then this action should be done. B is equals to B. Suppose if C greater than A and C greater than B happens, then B is equals to C. These are various actions, right? So we have three set of actions. Action 1, action 2, action 3 with respect to these decisions. So here I'm representing when action 1 needs to be performed, action 2 needs to be performed, and action 3 needs to be performed. So in rule 1, this is the rule. Okay, here we are representing as rule 1. So in rule 1, if decision A and decision B is true, the condition A and condition B is true, then we need to follow the action 1, right? A greater than B, A greater than C, B is equal to A. This is action 1. So if decision C and decision D is true, then I need to execute this action 2. B is equals to B. Decision E and decision F is true, then I need to execute this action. B is equals to C. So I didn't represent that. Okay, this one. E and F. Okay. Okay. So this is about decision table. So this is called a decision step, and this is called decision step. This is called action step. These are the decisions and these are the actions. And what thing is? Yes. There are certain things, like suppose if you compare this A greater than B, action A, with B greater than C, whether these two are independent or is there a relation between these two decisions. If A greater than B and B greater than C, A greater than B, A greater than C happen, then what about the remaining cases? What about the remaining cases? So if A is, sorry, if A, I am going to write here, if A is greater than B, A is greater than C, what about B? What about the BC relation? So I am taking 2, 3 greater than 1. Okay, 3 greater than something. They are below, because we don't write about this B and C. B greater than C or B less than C, it doesn't matter, right? Right? But A is greater than this B and A is greater than this C, because we have taken like this. Suppose if the condition is like, if A greater than B, so in another logic, we are going to write like this, right? A greater than C, something like this. So in this case, we will get to know between the relation of, between the relation, between this B and C relation. And what about this, in this condition, if AB happens, what about this C condition? It must or should not happen. So what about B greater than C? Suppose if you are thinking that it must happen, say yes. Okay? Suppose if it is not happening, that just simply should not happen, then you please type N. Otherwise, you type I. In chat. Have you understood my question? I'm going to explain once again. Here, there are two conditions for action one. The action one consists of two conditions. A greater than B, A greater than C, okay? So when these two things are true, I'm comparing with other condition, B greater than C. What about B greater than C? If you feel that B greater than C should be true, then you please type yes. If you feel that B greater than C must not be true, then you please type N. If you say that it can be anything, it may or may not happen, it doesn't bother the action one, you please type I. This is for you. Yes, somebody is responding in chat. Very good. I. Okay, very good. Very good. Excellent. This is simple mathematics, right? Pujita, Sri, Saryu, Jayasri, Shamila, Monica. Okay, you people understood it very quickly. Okay, good. Because it's just mathematics. Because we don't know in this perspective, in this context of a condition, A greater than B and A greater than C, we are taking together. We don't know the relation between B and C. B may be greater than C or B may be less than C. We don't know that, right? So whatever may be that case, action one can be executed, right? Depending on the AB conditions. So due to that, simply in case of this C condition, you no need to represent with a cross mark. You can represent with I mark. It's like a don't care term. Okay. This is not true. So I. So what about the B greater than A? We are saying that A greater than B and A greater than C. Right? Then is it possible to have this condition? No, right? So B greater than A must not happen, right? So D is not happening. D is not happening. So must not happen. So if you feel that the particular condition should not be true at that moment, then simply you represent with a cross. If you feel that the particular condition may or may not happen, it doesn't bother this situation. In this situation, okay? So it won't have I for all times. Here it may be I. In next condition, it is true, right? It is true. It is saying yes. But in this situation, it is I. Okay? So these sort of things you need to represent. So once you prepare the complete decision table, then again you need to revise the decision table by substituting yes or no in place of this I. You will get two combinations for each I, right? Once you got this decision table, then you need to simplify the expressions. Write the expressions for each action and then simplify the expression. Each node you need to write the expression, then simplify those expressions, okay, using Boolean algebra rules or KV charts. KV charts. So what is KV chart here? KV chart is a refinement of this K map, Connor Beach chart, okay, which is another scientist. Okay, he refined the corner map. So this is about the purpose of the decision table. Okay, this is covered, right? This is also covered. So how to represent decision table? So what is the meaning of decision table? Suppose if you feel that for this particular entry, I have taken this example, okay? So printer is printing. Printer does not print. It's not printing anything. And but there is no red light flashing and printer is unrecognized. Then you need to check whether the power is available to the printer or not, whether the computer and this printer are connected or not, and next whether the software is installed or not. These type of things are very useful in preparing a manual. So this is a decision table. Okay, so how you are going to represent the condition here? Yes means it must happen. No means it must not happen. I means it may or may not happen. Condition plays no part in that rule. B greater than C is nowhere relevant to the A greater than B, B greater than C. Okay, so it is immaterial. It is immaterial to that rule. That's why we are specifying with it. So sometimes we need to represent default condition also. What needs to be done? If all these things are not working, then what condition? If all these things are not working, in default case, we need to do some other action. Okay, next, decision table process. So you need to explain the same table. So how would that means how the action one is going to be executed, how this action two is going to be executed, when this condition true is going to be true. So all rules you need to explain. That is decision table process. So what about this graph? Now how do you got this graph? This graph is a conversion of this flow graph. Simply the conversion of flow graph. So in the flow graph, we represented all the decisions and their paths, right? And their actions. So how many decisions are there? There are four decisions, A, B, C, D, and three actions, 1, 2, 3. So in this case, you need to observe what are the paths that leads to this action one. Am I audible to you? Am I audible to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. So, what are the paths that leads to this action one? So, here in action one, we can observe only one single path. Okay, and just travel back to see. This is the path for action one. Please mute yourself. Okay. So, if there is anything, you can unmute and speak. Okay. Okay, so this is a path. So here we need to consider the label for the path. Okay, yes. That means it's true. A is true, then it's going to happen. Okay, so if that particular condition is absent in the path, that means it is I. Okay, immaterial case. It's immaterial condition. We don't know. That may or might not happen. It's having any role. Within this to execute the action here, okay? So simply you consider that there are A, yes, C is absent, right? So immaterial I in place of C, we need to keep this I because C is not present here, okay? So then simply for D it is yes. So it is about action one. It is reaching action one. So action one, yes. For action one, there is one more path you can see here. This is another path. So A is yes, B is no. Okay, B plus no. Next, C is absent. So I, D is also absent. So I. So yes, no, I. Okay, this is about C. This is about C and this is about D. Okay, these two are absent in the path. Simply represent with I and I. So here two paths are over. These two rules belongs to action one. What about action two then? So if you observe action two, we can see three paths here, right? This path. Okay. So what about this path? We focus on this. A yes, B yes, C is absent. So I. So D bar no, yes I know. So yes I know. Okay, that is rule three. So come to the other path. A no, B absent. So I, C yes, D is also absent. So no I, yes I. That is another path for action two. What about the other path? A no, C no. That means B is absent. So no I, no yes. No, I know yes. Next, what about the action three? So these three paths are over for action two. Now come to the point of action three. No, B is absent. So I, no. So come to action three. No, I, no, right? So these rules are over now. All the paths are completed. Okay. So in place of action one, we are keeping S here. In place of action two rules, we are keeping S here. In place of action three, we are keeping S here. Okay, in action three part. I already told you that these are respective values. For condition A, yes. For condition B, it is yes. For condition C, I. For condition D, yes. This is about action one, action two, action three. Okay. So once you completed the station table, then you need to consider the immaterial cases. How to consider the immaterial cases? Simply, you substitute yes or no. Yes for one time, no for another time. You're going to have two combinations for each I, pattern. Okay? Here first, yes. Consider it as yes. Yes, 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 no. Yes, no. Next, yes, no, yes, no. Yes, no, yes, no. Okay. Once it is completed, yes, no, yes, no. Yes, no, yes, no. Yes, no, no, no. Yes, no, no, no. Okay. What about these actions? These remain same. Yes, no. These two are related to the action one. So, rule 1.1, 1.2. Okay. Next, coming to the point of second one. It is related to action two, right? So, no, yes. No, yes. Rule 2.1, rule 2.2. So you need to consider the immaterial cases like this. Next, expansion. So what is the expansion? This is called expansion. You consider the condition A, B, C, D. Rule 1. Condition A is always true. How many related rules you see? Condition A is always true. So that means here you have one I, right? You need to represent Y or N here. The previous is just one example to consider this immaterial cases to generate a new decision table. Here we are dealing with the previous example. We are continuing the previous problem. So if you substitute Y or N, what happens here? Here you will get a two combinations for this rule one, right? So one is y, second one is y, y, n, y, second one is y, y, n, y. You can either follow like this or simply you can keep y or n in place of that. Just simply consider this one. For C and D, you have two i's. That means you are going to get this. Suppose if C is Y, D is N. Sorry. N, N. or ny, or here yy. So you can follow either some order, no problem. Okay, any order is okay. So here, for rule two, for this rule two, the a is always true. So simply you keep four y's, because here we get four combinations because of this two i's. Okay, maybe you have done the same thing in case of K-map, solving the digital logic, converting the outputs in Boolean expressions, right? But in digital logic design, you have done the same thing, right? If you consider the don't get them, it's going to happen. So yy, and nn. And here, what about ind? That can be ny, nn, yn, yy. So the order can be anything, no problem. Okay, but it should be like this. Okay, next, coming to the rule three, there is only one I, so you will get only two sequence, two length combinations. It's not two length. This is one combination yyyn, and this another combination yynn. You need to read like this. That means it is rule 3.1. This is 3.2. Okay, you can also indicate like this: 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4. In 2.1, we have y, n, n, y. This is 3.1. Okay. So in case of rule 4, you have two i's. So simply you can mention for a, rules can be discarded because they are not possible. They are together, they are not possible. No action is going to happen during that time. You can avoid those rules. Yes, to get the output n12. Where is n12 here? Yes, n12 plus. Either it might happen. Please, what is output node here? This node is output node 2 node. So how to get the resultant by this node? If you please, the path it has different paths, right? So one path is through this n12. So N12, either through this N12, or you can go through this N8 C bar, or you can also go through this N6 B bar C bar, right? So what is the other path here? Other path is also here. N6 B bar C bar, yes, N6 B bar C bar, or N8. That means N8 means up to this. Don't consider only starting from this point. Okay, up to this is called N8. The path up to this is called N8. The path up to 6 is called N6. Okay, N6 B bar C bar, N8 C bar. Okay, N8 C bar, or it might be like N12. So N12 plus N8 C bar plus N6 B bar C bar. So how to compute this N12? So N12 can be computed using N11 plus. Where is N11 here? N11 plus. Either we can go through this path, or we can go through this path. A bar B C bar. So that's why. Sorry, A bar B C, not C bar. So like that, you need to write the expression, and this is similar to the DLD logic framing. Okay, in DLD, you need to generate the output, right? Output expression for the given circuit, right? In similar way, you need to generate the given expression for the given flow graph. You need to generate the expression for the given flow graph. So this is going to be like this. You can simply evaluate all these things, and finally you will come up with some expression, right? So that expression can be valid using Boolean algebra. So these algebra expressions are similar everywhere, right? In DLD also use the same thing, the same logics. So a into 0 is 0, ab is ba, right? So that means you can add two gates in any manner, right? So ab is ba, no problem. You can change those things. Here we are talking about the path names. So what are these ABCs? These are path names. Okay, these are not decisions. if you mention print A, print B, if you alter their sequence, doesn't matter. Okay, but suppose if you write print A plus plus, we are not thinking about that. Suppose if you have this sort of thing like. Print percentage D A plus plus. Something A plus B. Okay. If you change the order of these two statements, maybe this is one path, it's following one path, one statement, it's following another path statement. Suppose if you change the order of these statements, AB is not equal to BA. It is different. We are not talking about this. Okay. Here, our consideration is these all are independent. Okay. That's why we are able to change AB is equals to BA. So here, this statement is not independent of this statement. We are not going to consider these two statements as independent statements, right? So if they are independent, then that means it is similar to the logic circuit, how we are dealing with. Okay, in logic circuit, it's possible. This gate output can be, if the two gate, different gates are in sequence, we can alter those sequence, no problem. A similar logic is there. So please follow these formulas. Okay. So we are trying to next. Applying the KV charts. I think I already explained this concept, right? This is similar to the K-map only. So what about this one here? What is the value of B in both cases? Just wait. Let's start with this two. Suppose one is present in these two places, what is the value here? This value represents A is always one, so it represents A. B can be anything, either 0 or 1, just this yields A value. B, suppose if B is 1 always, then you will get B. That means here it is 0, 1, right? 0, 1, 1, 1. This is A bar B plus AB. Am I right? A bar plus A. This is 1. So you will get B. Whether you are or not, I don't know. I hope you people are familiar with this K maps. You know, I don't need to explain even, right? Whether you, how many of you familiar with the K map evaluation? This U type Y or N? Somebody raise their hand. Just you type Y or N. Okay, you are familiar with K-map evaluation, right? Because it's very important subject in gate, right? So if you take a common, you will get a B value as 1. So this total yields value 1. That means wherever, suppose if you have expression like A bar B, AB, then you are going to represent ones in those positions. Okay, if you have only two variable, you will get this sort of four blocks, right? Four blocks, and you need to keep one in the respective position. Okay, so it is by on observation, you will get A value either 0 or 1. It might happen here. The value is B, just end up with B. Suppose if you have like this, the B A value A bar, you are going to have yield value A bar. If it is like this, if these two terms are present, then the value is B bar. So, similarly here. So you need to join like this, right? Two elements, four elements. I'm not going much deeper because you're already familiar with this. It's already covered in DLD, right? If two elements are present, What does it mean? A bar, this position is A bar B bar. A is 0, B is 0. That means A bar B bar plus this is AB. Right? So it is going to represent if and only if PA, if and only if P. That means if A bar, that means B is not happening, A is not happening. If A is happening, B is also happening. So they will occur together. Right? So here AB bar plus A bar B means exclusive OR. That means if A happens, B should not happen. B must not happen. We can easily use the must word here. If B happens, A must not happen. That is exclusive OR. So if it is like this, this value is A plus B, this value is A bar plus B. So based on this, we can evaluate. So for three variables also, it is the same. Okay? You are familiar with this, right? You can also join the ends. So for three variables, you need to keep like 0001, 1110, and here 01. This value represent, what is this value? A bar B, because A is 0, B is 1. So A bar B, and this is C bar. This is the value. Sorry, A bar C, this is the value. So like that. You can join two ones like this or like this. Or you can also join links like this to minimize the expression. If you minimize expression here, you can ignore this value. Things that are constant, right? So what about this value now? C bar and BC bar. So B is taking one value and C is taking zero value. So BC bar. And what about this? This is A, B bar, because C is changing different values. C can be anything. You can just leave that. That means if you take the C, if you consider the C values, that will become common. You can take this A, B bar as a common, then that becomes C plus C bar. C plus C bar value is always 1. Hence, you will get this A, B bar again. Okay, as we discussed before, as this case. So, hence, simply no need to consider that value. Similarly, like this also you can join. Like this also you can join four ones, single column or single, or you can also join at the ends. So this is exactly similar to the K-map, right? Exactly similar to the one. And why we call it as refined means we are applying this one to the path expressions. So here AB are not two normal variables, they are paths. Okay, you can also join like this and join like this, join like this. Multiple values we are going to get. This is the fourth unit. I'll give you some expressions, okay? So that you can build the KV charts for them and to lay the expression. Next class, I am going to give you the expressions. Please respond to the attendance. Somebody send why? For what? Surekha. Okay. So one thing is, if you are not getting the invitation through mail, okay, you please send your mail ID. Because in between, I'm not going to come to this screen and admit you. It's not possible for me. Okay, I just waited for so many times. So many times I gave you chance to join in between, but it is not good practice.